सरस्वती वाजेभिर्वाजिनीवती धीनामवित्र्यवतु आनो दिवो बृहतः पर्वतादा सरस्वती यजतागन्तु यज्ञम् वाग्देव्यै नमः। सुप्रभातम्। The different streams of yoga from Bhagavad Gita basically deals with our basic characteristics, and these characteristics are followed by the actions which we do and where they will lead to. If you consider the yoga as a regular practice, as well as the yoga as a skillful action, one has to understand his own nature first. The basic natures, as we know, well aware of that, the three qualities which are emerged out of the Prakriti, they are Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. Obviously, each and everyone needs to have these three qualities. You cannot be completely sattvic whenever you are in the normal world as a normal being. As well as sattva, rajas, tamas, all three are very much necessary. If you look at the nature, the trees, the mountains, the stones, all these are more dominated or more subtler in nature with tamoguna or the tamas or the inertia. If there is no inertia, the mountain cannot stand still. They will always running, even mountains also. The trees cannot stand still. So they have to have their own nature. Similarly, even if you don't have the inertia, to some extent you can't sit properly for some time. Otherwise, if you are more rajasic, you are unable to sit. If you are sattvic, then you can have balance on both the tamas as well as the rajas. So balancing factor is the sattva guna. When you are sitting in any session, if you are doing any activities, that inertia should be maintained to focus for some time. Say example, if you want to sit, that inertia content is necessary. But at the same time, the body stands still and the mind must be engaged using the rajas power. But between these, body as well as the mind, the sattva should balance. The sattva is the balancing factor named as the buddhi. That's why one of the verses, buddhi yukto jahatiha ubhe sukrata duskrute tasmat yogaya yujyasva yoga karma sukaushalam. Yoga karma sukaushalam. When the action can become more skillful if you use your buddhi, the intellectual discrimination power. The buddhi is dominated by more sattva guna. So sattva guna is utilized to balance both rajas as well as the tamas, inertia. So here the dynamism as well as the inertia are under control of the sattva guna, who is named to be yoga karmasu kaushalam. A person, he attains the skillful in each and every action to its perfection. Until and unless we have the skillfulness, we cannot be successful. You take few examples. A homemade, a cleaner comes to your home. If you make the statement, don't come tomorrow onwards to my home for cleaning and all, we will have other option, then she never gets scared. Immediately she makes the statement, if you don't take me, I have a lot of homes to do my duty. What that confidence she has got? Confidence is skillfulness. She know what she is doing and she can do the same thing in other homes also. She is very much confident what she has learned. You take an example of an electrician. He is a skillful fellow. I will give you the live example of our own campus. The entire electricity which is maintained by an uneducated fellow. No engineer, no planning, nothing is there. If you look at all our new buildings and old buildings, he plans, he make all electrical circuit, whatever the design you need. He's an illiterate, uneducated, he knows what is the amount of amps needed, voltage needed, what is the amount of the load needed for everything, he knows everything without studying anything. How it is possible? Skillfulness. If you ask him to go out of the campus, he will not get scared because he has lot of confidence on his own skillfulness. If you take the carpenter example, if you have some problem in the door, you cannot repair it and you need to wait for him until he comes to your home for repair. And if you say, if you don't come, I will find better options, then he will not get scared. Meaning, the people who have confidence on themselves, it is just because of the skillfulness. Can't you say that they have more focused on their work, skillful in action? So this is called Yoga Karmasa Kaushalam. The expertise or the excellency in their own field. But if you take the modern educated students or the employers, more suicidal rate can be found in only in the educated elite families, not with the cowmaids or the shepherds or the common people. You never find it. Why? Somewhere our education system is failing to give confidence. A few years back, an incident happened in US. A fellow from India, from Tamil Nadu, who has graduated from IIT Madras, B.Tech, also graduated from MBA, and he has got a good job in America with good paid salary around 4 lakhs per annum. Family was running well. And one fine day, one of our educationists from India used to frequently travel to give the seminars and lectures. And he was invited to that particular home where that fellow was working. And people asked, why should I visit his home? No, there is a problem, please do visit and console them. What was the problem? That fellow has handled suicide. Why? His wife told the story. One of his friend was removed from the job. Not his job, his friend's job. And the moment, you know, in the Western countries, most of the countries, the moment you have lost the job, within next 10-15 seconds, your email will be blocked. They never allow your official email ID to operate. And they will keep ready all your bags, luggage and checks even. And you will not allow to enter into your office also. They will be kicked out. They feel that you are no more required to the company, they will kick out. So one of his friends was removed like this. And this fellow from India is a very brilliant fellow, confident fellow, got to know that next term may be it's mine. Thinking this, he has lost his hope, and the same day he told his wife and the parents, go to marketing, shopping, he has paid lot of money. Go for shopping. By the time they returned to home, he was suicided, hanged. Why? There is no confidence. There is no Atma Vishwasa. So, wherever we are, whatever we learn or do actions, we should develop some confidence so that without any worries, stress or the tension, we can be more successful. If you look at the suicidal rate in the India, it is more among the students' community. Just 2-3 months back it happened in Bangalore city. One of the general manager, his daughter was studying in the 9th standard. And one fine day, she had to face one competitive exam in her school. It is a school competitive exam, nothing like IAS or IPS exam. Then mother told, go and get study without wasting your time in watching the TV or mobile or laptop. She said, no, today I have a party with my friend, I need to go. Mother insisted, tomorrow you have exam. Then that's all. Next 1 hour, she went into the first chair, suicided, hanged. Then somewhere, our education system is failing to build up the confidence in the students too. She was a rank student in all the years, scoring 95, 96, 98%. But she could not get that confidence at that moment. Even though I attend party, even though I watch the TV and all, I could able to face the exam. It's why buddhi yukto jahatiha ubhe sukrata duskrute. Whatever the activities we do, use the buddhi, intellectual power to develop the confidence. Tasmat yogaya yujasva. Even if you take up the yoga as a profession or the career, let us try to understand and practice in its core so that we should not be floated in the stream of the entire world. That's why anything what we learn, the practice what we do, it must give 100% confidence, but that confidence comes only whenever you gain the intellectual power, that is the sattva guna. The continuous practice of yoga surely will take you to the sattvic in nature. That sattva is the balancing the both rajoguna as well as tamoguna, and you will get more skillfulness in each and every action, and a yogi becomes a perfected in his yoga sthiti. This is what the verse gives the message. So, we having understood these three gunas, obviously as we have got human birth, we should have these three qualities, but use the sattva guna to balance both tamas as well as rajas to gain more successful and confidence in the life. Thank you very much. Om asato ma satyamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya pratyorma Shine.